So when you are, if you have to do stairs for the immediate, you're going to do step two, go up with your good, down with your bad. Okay? Mm-hmm. Go up, up with your good, down with your bad. So, you know, even though you're facing this way, when you're facing forward, you still go down with your bad. Okay? Up with, okay, because, yeah. Because your bad, when it's straight, right, it can support a lot of weight. So it can go up this way, right? Even when you're stepping down, now you can take, put the other way down. Mm-hmm. Right? So once for instance, yep, let's turn around, get up there and turn around. Now, go, yep, yep, up with your good, right? Go all the way up. Now when you're stepping down, down off a regular step, that left leg has to control and support all of your weight. Mm-hmm. This one, it's just supporting your weight when it's straight and locked. Just remember that. Up with the good, down with the bad.
That's how I did it.
Okay. That's how we're doing it for now. Now that we said that, we're going to do just the opposite. Turn around. So that is for when you're out in public and you got to climb a lot of stairs. Over the next couple, 2-3 weeks, you're going to do it. Next 3 weeks, you're going to be doing it that way. Okay?
Like the way we just did it?
The way you just did it. Right. But now we're going to do just the opposite of that. Because we're going to work on training that actually weak muscle to make it stronger and stable. So, hold, let me scoot this over here. Now you're going to hold on to this right here. Yeah. Put your hand over there. Now you're going to go up with your bat. Okay? And now down with the bat, though. So down, we still go down with it. Up with the bat, down with it. Reason why we don't go down with our good, because the negatives, remember we talked about eccentric control, concentric control, the when you're lowering something down, that takes a lot more stress, a lot more strength, puts more stress on the leg. Mm-hmm. So we will eventually do that, just not today. I don't know if we got to the point where last time we were here, did we talk about insoles?
Insole?
Or your shoes? You're inside your shoes? Just for your feet. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, sorry. We'll talk about it when you get close to the 3 months. Or yeah, maybe before you start running. Mm-hmm. Your feet are kind of starting to go kind of flat. You're going to go about halfway down. So not to your knee, your legs parallel to the hip.
Leave my knee brace on?
Yeah, leave your knee brace on. It adds a little bit more weight without too much weight.
Like that?
Yep. Testing the waters. Okay, so if we put this on your exercise program, do you think you can behave yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Right? What do I mean by that?
Mini.
Mini. Okay, do you think you'll stick with the mini?
Mini, yep.
We'll be dropping it down more in next week, but right now we're just trying to get everything used to moving that way without hurting.
Yep.
Okay. open up, this is a clamshell. Open up, leave your heels together, open up your knees. Don't let your hips roll backwards. Keep your hips right there. Open it up, boom, right there. Yep, do that 10 times. Keep going. Keep going. So you're going to do clamshells, you're going to do mini wall squats at home. And you're already kind of doing the little booty squeezes, right?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, lay down on your tummy. Okay, try to keep your legs straight, do the booty squeeze, and now lift up your legs, both of them. There you go. And then just down. Hold it for 2-3 seconds, and then you put it down, okay? So now you're just going to start lifting up both legs same time. Mm-hmm. All right, keep the legs straight though, don't bend the knee.
All right,
squeeze and lift. There you go, 1, 2, 3 and down. Got it?
Yep.
All right, do that 10 times. I'm going to update those new exercises and you'll be done for today.
All right.